Chapter 14. In the last chapter, we described how Baba's word and grace cured many incurable diseases. Now we shall describe how Baba blessed Mr. Ratanji Wadia and gave him an issue. The life of this saint is naturally sweet. His various doings, eatings, walking, and his natural sayings are also sweet. His life is bliss incarnate. Sai gave bliss to his devotees as a means of remembrance. He gave them various stories of duty and action, which ultimately led them to true religion. His object may be that people should live happily in this world, but they should be ever cautious and achieve the object of their life, that is, self-realization. We get human body as a result of merits in past births, and it is worthwhile that with its aid we should attain devotion and liberation in this life. So we should never be lazy but always be on the alert to gain our goal of life. If you hear the leelas of Sai daily, you will always see him day and night. You will remember him in your mind. When you assimilate a Sai in this way, your mind will lose its fickleness. And if you go on in this manner, it will finally be merged in pure consciousness. Ratanji of Nanded. Now let us come to the main story of this chapter. In Nanded, in Nizam state, there lived a Parsi mill contractor and trader by name Ratanji Shapurji Wadia. He had amassed a large amount of money and had acquired fields and lands. He had cattle, horses and conveyance and was very prosperous. In all outward appearances, he looked very happy and contented, but inwardly he was not so. Providential dispensation is such that no one in this world is completely happy. And rich Ratanji was no exception to this. He was liberal and charitable, gave food and clothing to the poor and helped all in various ways. The people took him to be a good and happy man, but Ratanji thought himself miserable, as he had no issue, male or female, for a long time. Just as Kirtan, singing glories of the Lord without love or devotion, song without rhythmical accompaniments, Brahmin without the sacred thread, proficiency in all arts without common sense, pilgrimage without repentance, and ornamentation without a necklace are futile and useless, so is a householder without an issue. Ratanji always brooded on this matter and said in his mind, "Would God be ever pleased to grant me a son?" He thus looked more morose and did not relish his food day and night. He was enveloped with anxiety as to whether he would ever be blessed with a son. He had a great regard for Dasganu Maharaj. He saw him and opened his heart before him. Dasganu advised him to go to Shirdi, take Baba's darshan, fall at his feet and seek his blessings and pray for an issue. Ratanji liked the idea and decided to go to Shirdi. After some days, he went to Shirdi, took Baba's darshan and fell at his feet. Then opening a basket, he took out a beautiful garland of flowers and placed it around Baba's neck and offered him a basket full of fruits. With reverence, he then sat near Baba and prayed to him, saying, "Many persons who find themselves in difficult situations come to you, and you relieve them immediately. Hearing this, I have anxiously sought your feet. Please do not disappoint me." Sai Baba then asked him for dakshina of rupees 5, which Ratanji intended to give, but added that he had already received 3 to 14 from his 3 rupees 14 annas from him, and that he should pay the balance only. Hearing this, Ratanji was rather puzzled. He could not make out as to what Baba meant. That was the first time he thought that he had come to Shirdi, and how it was that Baba said that he had earlier got 3 rupees 14 annas from him. He could not solve the riddle, but he sat at Baba's feet and gave the balance of the dakshina asked for, explained to Baba fully as to why he came and sought his help and prayed that Baba should bless him with a son. Baba was moved and told him not to worry, and that thenceforth his bad days had ended. He then gave him udi, placed his hand on his head and blessed him, saying that Allah would satisfy his heart's desire. Then after taking Baba's leave, Ratanji returned to Nanded and told Dasganu everything that took place in Shirdi. He said that everything went on well there, that he got Baba's darshan and blessing with Prasad. But there was one thing which he could not understand. Baba said to him that he had got ₹3.14 annas before. Please explain as to what Baba meant by this remark. He said to Dasganu, I never went to Shirdi before, and how could I give him the sum to which Baba referred? To Dasganu too it was a puzzle, and he thought much over it for a long time. Sometime afterwards it struck to him that Ratanji had received some days ago a Mohammedan saint by name Mauli Sahib in his house and had spent some money for his reception. This Mauli Sahib was a well-known saint of Nanded and worked as a porter. When Ratanji decided to go to Shirdi, this Mauli Sahib turned up at Ratanji's house. Ratanji knew him and loved him, so he gave a small party in his honor. Dasganu got from Ratanji the memo of expenses of this reception, and everybody was wonderstruck to see that the expenses amounted to exactly ₹3. Nothing more, nothing less. They all came to know that Baba was omniscient. That was that though he lived in Shirdi, he knew what happened outside, far away from Shirdi. In fact, he knew the past, present and future and could identify himself with anybody. In this particular instance, how could he know the reception given to Mauli Sahib and the amount spent therefore, unless he could identify himself with him and be one with him? Ratanji was satisfied with this explanation, and his faith in Baba was confirmed and increased. In due time, he was blessed with a son, and his joy knew no bounds. It is said that he had in all a dozen issues, but out of which only 4 survived. In a footnote towards the end of this chapter, it is stated that Baba told Rao Bahadur Hari Vinayak Sate after the death of his first wife to remarry, and that he would get a son. R.B. Sate married second time. The first 2 issues by his wife were daughters, and he therefore felt very despondent. But the 3rd issue was a son. Baba's words did come true, and he was satisfied. Dakshina. Now we shall close this chapter with a few points about Dakshina. It is a well-known fact that Baba always asked for Dakshina from his people who went to see him. Somebody may ask a question, if Baba was a fakir and preferably non-attached, why should he ask for Dakshina and care for money? We shall consider this question broadly now. First, for a long time, Baba did not take anything. He stored burnt matches and filled his pocket with them. He never asked anybody for anything, whether he be a devotee or otherwise. If anybody placed before him a paisa or 2, he purchased oil or tobacco. He was fond of tobacco, for he always smoked a bidi or chilam. Then some persons thought that they should not go to saints empty-handed, and therefore placed some copper coins before Baba. If a paisa was placed before him, he used to pocket it. If it was two paise coin, it was returned immediately. Then after Baba's fame had spread far and wide, people began to flock in numbers, and Baba began to ask darshana from them. It is said that in the Shruti that puja of the gods is not complete unless a golden coin was offered. If a coin was necessary in the puja of the gods, why should it not be in the puja of the saints also? Ultimately, the Shastras laid it down that when one goes to see God, King, Saint or Guru, he should not go empty-handed. He should offer something, preferably money. In this connection, we may notice the precepts recommended by the Upanishads. The Brihadaranyaka Upanishads says that the Lord Prajapati advised the gods, men and demon, by one letter, Da. The gods understood by this letter that they should practice Dhamma, that is self-control. The men thought of or understood that they should practice Dana, that is charity. The demons understood that they should practice Daya, that is compassion. To men, charity charity or giving was recommended. The teacher in the Taittiriya Upanishad exhorts his pupils to practice charity and other virtues. Regarding charity, he says, give with faith, or even without it, give with magnanimity, that is liberally, give with modesty, awe and sympathy. In order to teach the devotees the lesson of charity and to remove their attachment to money and thus to purify their minds, Baba extracted Dakshina from them. But there was this peculiarity, as Baba said, that he had to give back 100 times more of what he had received. There are many instances in which this has happened. To quote an instance, Mr. Gopal Rao Bodas, the famous actor, says in his Marathi autobiography that on Baba's pressing him often for Dakshina, he emptied his money bag before him. The result of this was, as Mr. Bodas says, that in latter life, he never lacked money, as it came to him abundantly. There were also secondary meanings of Dakshina in many cases in which Baba did not want any pecuniary amount. To quote two instances, Baba asked rupees 15 as Dakshina from Professor G.J. Narke, who replied that he did not have any money. Then Baba said, I know you have no money, but you are reading Yoga Vasishta. Give me Dakshina from that. Giving Dakshina in this case meant deriving lessons from the book and lodging them in the heart where Baba resides. Second, in the second case, Baba asked a certain lady, Mrs. R.A. Thakkar, to give rupees 6 as Dakshina. The lady felt pained as she had nothing to give. Then her husband explained to her that Baba wanted 6 inner enemies, lust, anger, avarice, etc., to be surrendered to him. Baba agreed with this explanation. It is to be noted that though Baba collected a lot of money by Dakshina, he would distribute the whole amount the same way that the next morning he would become a poor fakir as usual. When Baba took his Mahasamadhi, even after receiving thousands and thousands of rupees as Dakshina for about 10 years, he had only a few rupees in his possession. In short, Baba's main object in taking Dakshina from his devotees was to teach them the lessons of renunciation and purification. Postscript. Mr. B.V. Dev of Thana, retired Mamaldar and a great devotee of Baba, has written an article on this subject, Dakshina, in Sri Sai Leela magazine, volume 2, page number 6 to 26, in which he says as follows. Baba did not ask Dakshina of all. If some gave Dakshina unasked, he sometimes accepted it. At other times, he used to refuse it. He asked it if certain from certain devotees only. He never demanded it from those devotees who thought in their mind that Baba should ask for it and then they should pay it. If anybody offered it against his wish, he never touched it and he kept it there. He asked him to take it away. He asked for small or big amounts from devotees according to their wish, devotion and convenience. He asked it even of women and children. He never asked of all the rich for it, nor of all the poor. Baba never got angry with those to whom he asked Dakshina and who did not give it. If any Dakshina was sent through some friend who forgot to hand over the same to Baba, he reminded him of it and made to pay it. On some occasions, Baba used to return some from the amount tendered as Dakshina and ask the donor to guard it or keep it in the shrine for worship. This procedure benefited the donor or devotee immensely. If anybody offered some more than he originally intended to give, he returned the extra amount. Sometimes he asked for some more Dakshina than what they originally intended to give, and if they had no money, asked them to beg, borrow from others. Of some, he demanded Dakshina 3 or 4 times a day. Out of the amount collected as Dakshina, Baba spent very little for his own sake, that is for buying chilam and fuel for his dhuni, and all the rest he distributed as charity to varying proportions to various persons. All the All the paraphernalia of the Shirdi Sansthan was brought by various rich devotees at the instance and suggestions of Radha Krishna Mai. Baba always used to get wild and scolded those who brought any costly and rich articles. He said to Mr. Nana Sahib Chandorkar that all his property consisted of one cowpin, one stray piece of cloth, one kafni and a turmal, and that all the people troubled him with bringing all these unnecessary costly articles. Women and wealth are the two main obstacles in the way of our paramartha, and Baba had provided in Shirdi two institutions, that is Dakshina and Radha Krishna Mai, for whenever they come to him, he demanded Dakshina from them and asked them to go to the school, Radha Krishna Mai's house. If they stood these two tests well, that is, if they showed that they were free from attachment for woman and wealth, their progress in spirituality was rapid and assured by Baba's grace and blessings. Mr. Dev has also quoted passages from Gita and Upanishads and shown that charity given in a holy place or to a holy personage conduces to the donor's welfare. What is more holy than Shirdi and its presiding deity, Sai Baba? Bow to Shri Sai. Peace be to all.